When was the last time that you saw an implementation of the visitor design pattern in .NET? Has it gone extinct? In a way, yes. Visitor is dead in C#. But don't cry for it, that is a sign of success. The ultimate goal of every design pattern is to disappear by the end, to become part of the language syntax. And so the story of visitor in C# is the story of success. Let me show you how that happened. This is the sample code, some books with their authors. We don't need the visitor here, but we'll need it pretty soon, and I will implement it the way you will find it, for example, in the Gang of Four book. Then you will see that that traditional visitor implementation will become obsolete. So what could we want to do with these books? I might want to just print them out. Like, iterate through all the publications, print them out, and that is pretty much all. That is the portion of this code we will have to address soon. And these are the models we are dealing with. This is the publication implementation. It has zero or more authors, so we will need to format the list of authors and the title of the book. The more complicated part of this model is the author's name. That is where complexity is hiding. Look here. There are three kinds of personal names. A simple name with first and last name, then a mononym with only a single name, and eventually the compound name, which may include middle names. Now, formatting the book details for display. That requires formatting the list of authors, and the list of authors consists of names which are polymorphic. That is, four methods for just one variation. Plus, there must be a support for that in the book, in the publication class, which is also formatting a sequence of personal names. That is, five methods to implement one variation. The problem the visitor is addressing is precisely this problem. You have a hierarchy of classes which is pretty much fixed. So if you need to add more and more and more methods to a hierarchy of classes and you want to avoid explosion of these classes, like having dozens of methods on each class in the hierarchy, then you implement the visitor. A visitor is a class which is visiting, or an object of the visitor class is visiting each of the separate implementations, the separate members of the hierarchy of classes, and doing something in that specific case. One method to visit the simple name. Whatever there is to do to transform a simple name object into some type T, implementation, concrete implementation of this method will do it. And another method to visit a mononymous name. And yet another to visit a compound name. This interface is defining an interface of a class, a concrete class, which is adding one single method to a hierarchy of classes in such way that you don't have to change any element of that hierarchy, any class in it. However, that will affect the hierarchy in one particular way. Each class must implement the accept method. There will be the abstract method accept at the root type. So every member of the hierarchy that supports the visitor design pattern must have this single method. But don't worry, it will be next to trivial. Every implementation in a derived class will look the same. Just let the visitor visit this. This is the riddle. But anyway, here is one in the second class and another one in the last one class. Each class will look exactly the same. Each call will resolve to a call to a different method in the visitor. And so, the simple name when calls visitor.visit of this, it will call the first method that receives the simple name, because compiler is compiling the simple name class, and it knows that it has the simple name object this, and then it invokes a concrete method that receives simple name. And now we will get on to implementing concrete visitor classes, and you will see how powerful this pattern indeed is. By the way, if you liked the video so far, please press the like button. That will help me promote this video. Thank you very much. And you can also subscribe to my channel and watch other videos I have published there. Let's get back. The very existence of the visitor in the system will affect consumers of that hierarchy of classes. One consumer is the publication class, which is containing multiple personal names. I will implement an alternate to string method, which is using the visitor. You will supply a concrete formatting with every call to this method, so this method can produce wildly different results depending on which concrete visitor you have passed to it. And this ultimate consumer will also use the visitor. Everything is right except that I need a concrete visitor implementation to be able to invoke this function. So let's start implementing concrete visitors. They will be the one that will produce common formatting, like if it has the simple name, it will just take the first and the last name of the author. Mononymous name will be just that. And from the compound name, it will have access to several components of this object, but it will only dig the first and the last name and ditch everything else. Concrete implementations of the visitor pattern require access to components of the target hierarchy of every concrete class type in the hierarchy. That puts pressure on encapsulation. You will encapsulate the components, but still you must expose them for reading publicly. But on the consuming end, the sun will shine. Look at this. In this example here, I have just selected how to format the book cover by selecting a concrete visitor that formats authors' names. What if I wanted a different printout? Well, supply an alternate implementation of the visitor. That's quite obvious. This one is displaying a full name. The difference is in the last method implementation with compound name, where it is using middle names that are available in this case. Yet another concrete implementation of the visitor that might be useful in academic publications. So we have three concrete implementations of the visitor, that is, three distinct methods added to the hierarchy of classes without touching a single class. I can add 50 methods if I wanted. And in a large project, I would add 50 methods to a hierarchy of classes without ever touching any of them. That is the power of visitor. At the consuming end, switch the object, apply a different object, and everything should work fine. Let me run the application. Here we have two distinct outputs, two substantially different outputs. They differ in the way the class is formatting the list of authors of a publication. That is exactly what we wanted. But then, an interface, a class for every implementation, a special accept method defined on all classes in the hierarchy, including the abstract accept method on the root of the hierarchy. Can we go without that? Yes. Let me tell you a secret about the visitor design pattern. It is a functional pattern. It is doing something we cannot do in object-oriented programming. It is effectively adding a functional design to an object-oriented model. And so, as C# is progressively growing more and more functional, it shouldn't surprise you that you can implement a visitor without adding a single class to your project. You can implement a visitor with a lambda if you want it. Let me show you. I'll create a static class just to be a home to concrete implementations of different kinds of visitors I plan to make. And then you use pattern matching of C# that we have today, for example, the switch expression, to convert every possible appearance of this abstract type into a string. You can use type test and set patterns, for example, to extract the mononym object, strongly typed object, to access its component and to format a string, or to capture a simple name object, again, access its components and format string in a bit different way. The difference between pattern matching and that implementation of the visitor with concrete classes is that in C# pattern matching, we must make every mapping exhaustive. This switch expression is not exhaustive, so we must append a catch-all pattern at the end. And the only thing we can do when somebody adds a new type to the hierarchy is to throw an exception. It was common to throw exceptions like argument exception here, but since .NET 7, we have a new exception type, which is specifically designed for tooling, but we can also use it in this situation, unreachable exception. This exception is useful in design when you want to specify a line of code that should never execute. If it executed, then there is a bug. This static extension method is in all respects equivalent to that heavyweight implementation of the visitor with the interface and with concrete class and with methods on every concrete class in the hierarchy we are covering. Defining a different mapping, a different visitor, if you like, is a piece of cake. Just define another method or an extension method like I'm doing. And that's it. Yet another for academic format. Consuming goes even easier than that of the visitor, because this time we can use the func delegate. And func delegate is ubiquitous. It exists. You can use it everywhere in your code. And here is that ultimate consumer. I will also transform it to use the func delegate. The call to toString below is compiling fine because there is that variant which expects the func delegate. But we must pass functions when calling this function. It is very easy this time. I can just pass the method group. But there is more flexibility here than that with the visitor. We can pass a lambda. We can pass a local function. You can implement the visitor this way impromptu by just defining a lambda that you will not reuse anywhere else if it is one-off implementation that you only need here. Nevertheless, when I run this code, you will see that it is working exactly the same as before. I didn't add more classes, I didn't add the new interface, I didn't implement all those methods, I just implemented one method per visitor kind, and the code is working exactly the same as before. This is pretty much all about visitors today. You don't need them, but you will implement them all around your code if you're inclined to designing your models in functional fashion. Let's compare these two kinds of implementations. This is the explicit visitor implementation, a class that implements an interface and has one method for each hand of the mapping. And here is the implicit visitor. I just made that term up, implicit visitor. It is line by line exactly the same as that explicit visitor implementation. The distinction is in the catch-all pattern. So, in the traditional visitor implementation, the compiler would tell you if somebody added new type to the hierarchy, making the breaking change to all the visitor implementations, they will fail to compile. With pattern matching, compiler will be satisfied, but you should be wary of those unreachable exceptions. If you see an unreachable exception, that is an indication that somebody has made a breaking change in the hierarchy of classes, and so you must revisit all the mappings, all those implicit visitors you made all around your project, and add one hand in each of those. No additional classes, no additional interface, nothing to see changed on the hierarchy of classes like that except method we had to add, nothing. Everything becomes transparent, implicit, and all you do is map all the classes in your system. I hope you have learned something useful in this video about the visitor pattern, one of the most beautiful patterns that exist, but one that is really going extinct in modern object-oriented languages because they are becoming more functional. That is the secret of visitors today. Again, if you liked this video, please press the like button, subscribe to my channel, watch other videos on my channel, and see you in the next episode.